Hello, I'm Ciprian, and I am the maintainer of Free Heroes 2 Enhanced, an engine recreation of Heroes 2. If you want to see what is Free Heroes 2 about, follow the link in the description. In this series of clips, I will review all Heroes games as a developer and as a casual player. I will give the review score up front to make it easier to understand my views about this game. I will rate this game 5 out of 10, meaning that if you don't play it, you don't lose much, especially as there are subjectively better games in the series, they are better in all the parts of the game, including graphics, mechanics, gameplay balance, music, and so on. Heroes of Might and Magic games are turn-based strategy games in the Might and Magic universe, created initially by New World Computing, and later from Heroes 5. They were developed under the umbrella of Ubisoft by various studios. The idea of the game is that you will have multiple castles and heroes. So here are the castles and here are the heroes. And they are used to conquer all the castles and overpower the enemies. So, to be clear, all the things started from somewhere, and here is where Hero series started from. So, let's see the things which I find them positive about this game. One part is that we have to take into account that the game is more than 20, I think even it's close to 23 years old, something like that. So it's more than 20 years of age, and you can see a lot of level of detail at every corner. So you'll see a lot of very nice pixel art, from the coins to the gems to resources to units to even, and I'm not sure if it was so visible, but let's build something first. So we will build, let's say, an archer range. You'll see this is a typical dialogue, and you can see that the detail is not only in the drone part, but the font, the color scheme, the resources, as I said before, but the buttons look like made out of stone or even the font looks like it's a bit handmade. So you'll see a lot of detail, which is very hard not to appreciate. You will see that is detail. It's not only in dialogues, but you'll find it that this detail is in, for example, here. Like, if you want to see what is the ultimate artifact, which improves the skills of your hero, what gives you money, the artifacts are here in this bar of the hero stats. All of them, all the details are in every dialogue, for better or for worse. The other part that maybe you can hear it or not is that it's the kind of nice ambiental sounds. Let's buy troops. This part may not sound much, but at that time, the game, which was as a reference, maybe people know it, is Command and Conquer. So the units were just few pixels wide, and even there were sounds, the sounds were not so great, or the graphics. The other part which we can really appreciate is that it has its own universe. which was started from King Bounty series, made by the same creator. But all in all, you will find that there is a lot of details. Some parts, though, are not so good. So I will go to the section of minuses. And one of minuses is that even the graphics are stylish, you will see many things that are not that good. And I'm not saying this as a judging. Also, I'm saying taking into account that the year was an old year. So taking still this into account, I will say that many parts could be improved, as at least playing as for now. The part which, for example, here in the battle, you notice that the battle feels like the animations look clunky because they are. Also, the units, if they will move backward, they will really move with the back, which looks really ugly. The units disappear from the battle without having a death animation or having any dead. There are many kind of hidden bugs and quirks. The even I appreciate the level of detail. You will see that, as I've shown maybe before, dialogues are misaligned sometimes. Here it's very well aligned, but if especially if there are resources, you'll find that the graphics are misaligned. Again, this is maybe just an annoyance, but you see here are two exit buttons, and they look really strange to have two buttons, one of them doing nothing. And every time when you go into the building, sometimes you see it. Why is like this? But you'll find many dialogues like missing, at least the buttons are a bit shifted or so on. And I will put also the ugly part. This is not a minus per se of the gameplay or the game, but it's important to put it. So one part which you will notice kind of very quickly is that compared with other Heroes games, at least you have very few maps. There are less than 35 maps, which is a shame. And also it doesn't have that the thing which next future Heroes games would have, at least some of them, which is a level editor, which reduces a lot the replayability. And some maps, as for my test, I found them really on the annoying side. So let's jump a bit to the conclusions, because I think people that are into this game, they already had an opinion even before watching this review. And I will say that the single advice I can give you at the end is only if you want to play the game just to know where Heroes game started from. So I will say this game, it misses many feature. You see, this is a bug, so it doesn't move. It moves just one click. It's not always happening, but okay, it's not always happening, but you'll find this kind of small annoyances, as I said. So let's imagine you would want to know where Heroes started from. So If this is your target, then you should buy it when the price is the lowest. And I will say that it has to be not only a sale. Let's say right now you can buy it from Georgia at around 10 euros. But if the sale is at 5 euros, I would say it's not worth the admission price. But if it's, let's say, 1.99 or 2.99, I think is the a fair price, especially when considering that all the other heroes have much more detail baked in. Okay, so I will I hope you like this review. If you like the series or this review in particular, or you don't like it, please write comments below. Also, if you want just to check Free Heroes 2, which is an open source recreation of Heroes 1, and it resembles to some, sorry, of Heroes 2, which resembles to some level to Heroes 1, take a look. It's open source, it's free, and maybe you may like it. Thank you for your time, and have a good one. Bye bye.